research team led by Teh-hui Kao, a Penn State professor of biochemistry and molecular biology, has discovered a large suite of genes in the petunia plant that acts to prevent it from breeding with itself or with its close relatives. In much the same way that human inbreeding sometimes results in genetic disease and inferior health, some inbred plants also experience decreased fitness and therefore have developed mechanisms to ensure that their offspring benefit from hybrid vigor, the mix that results when genetically distinct members of the same species breed. Humans have mechanisms to prevent inbreeding that are in part cultural. However, a plant can't just get up and move to the next town to find a suitable unrelated mate. So, some other system must be at work. Kao began to unravel the mystery of what he calls a non-self recognition system in the mid-1980s by studying the genetic sequence of petunias. Petunias, like many common garden plants, are hermaphroditic, possessing both male and female reproductive organs. This floral anatomy makes it easy for a plant's pollen to land on itself, resulting in self-fertilization and genetically inferior inbred offspring. To prevent self-fertilization, many flowering plants, including the petunia, have evolved a strategy called self-incompatibility, or the ability to recognize self and non-self components. In 1994, Kao's team discovered the first piece of the self-incompatibility puzzle in the petunia plant. They discovered a gene called S-RNase that controls self-incompatibility in the pistil, the plant's female reproductive organ. S-RNase allows the pistil to distinguish between self and non-self pollen, which is analogous to sperm cells, and specifically kills self pollen to prevent inbreeding. Later, in 2004, Kao's team discovered another gene called Type-1 SLF that controls self-incompatibility in pollen by distinguishing between self and non-self pistil S-RNase proteins. In 2010, Kao's team identified two additional self-incompatibility genes, type 2 and type 3 SLF. Types 1, 2, and 3 SLF genes, and possibly some additional types, all work in concert to prevent inbreeding by identifying many different types of non-self pistil S-RNase proteins. Interestingly, self-incompatibility in plants can be likened to the adaptive immune system in humans and other vertebrates. Just as plants distinguish between non-self and self to know which plants it should breed with and which it should reject as too similar, our bodies distinguish between non-self and self to know what to attack and what to leave alone. When pathogens enter our bodies, our T cells recognize them as foreign invaders and battle against them by triggering production of antibodies by B cells. But when this system goes awry, our bodies misidentify self as non-self and attack it. These attacks on our own tissues are known as autoimmune disorders. Arthritis and lupus are just a couple of examples. Just as we have evolved many different types of T-cell receptors to collectively recognize the many foreign antigens we might encounter in our environment, plants have evolved many versions of self-incompatibility genes. For ScienceCast, I'm Katrina Voss.